Following program is being brought to you in living color on NBC. Richard Hudnut, America's first name in beauty. Richard Hudnut, makers of Lip Quick, the world's first roll-on lip color. Color Glow, the first waterproof hair color rinse. Fashion Quick, the first no-odor home permanent. And Fabulous Light and Bright Hair Lightener presents The George Burns Show.
Just before I came upon the stage tonight, I had an argument that almost caused a fight. My producer said that dancing was the public's choice. Well, I said that the public much preferred the singing voice, but maybe I'm wrong. Maybe he's right. We'll soon find out because tonight's the night. Please, just to show the public, would you kindly display a pirouette, an attitude, a pas de bourrée? If you have the elevation for an entrechat, make it ringy-dingy with the cha-cha-cha. Please, add a variation to a theme by Bach. Elevate, releve, and really make it rock. Start a pas de deux, now a touche-té. Pas de bourrée, pas de bourrée. Maestro, please, now take it away.
Big star like you on my show.
You can't tell me. Well, try. Tell me, George. You know, we've got a whole hour. The show has just started.
Jack, I really mean it.
Well, George, your show can't miss. Now, look at the talent you've got. You got Grable, Bergen, Bobby Darin, the Hermes Pan Dancers, Jeff Alexander's music, and, of course, me.
Jack, you left somebody out.
Oh, I'm sorry. Your director, Greg Garrison.
Well, what show am I on? I know I'm working. I'm wearing makeup.
George, look, I was getting around to you. After all, this is an hour show, isn't it?
Well, see if you can squeeze me in before the closing credits.
You've got the most important job. You don't realize. You've got the most important job on this whole show.
Oh?
You're the host.
The host. Well, good. Now, what does the host do?
Are you kidding? What does... Look, when all of these great performers get up and do their wonderful numbers, who's the fella who does this?
I do this, huh?
What a talent.
You're right, Jack. I don't think there's anybody in show business who has a better pair of palms than I have. I got a surprise for you. I'm not only going to be the host, but I'm going to sing with Grable, with Bergen, with Darren, with the Hermes Pan Dancers, with Jeff Alexander's orchestra. And when the show is over, I'm singing with our director, Greg Garrison.
George, you've got me wrong. See, I love your singing. I think you've got a style that's your own. You got a great voice.
You do?
Sure. Look, I've never told you this.
Oh?
But after a golf game, when you take a shower at Hillcrest Country Club, I always take the shower next to yours.
Just to hear me sing?
I don't even turn on the water.
Really, Dak?
George, many a day I've come home to Mary, dirty but happy.
You sure it's not to save money on towels?
You're corny. But look, George, I really love your singing.
Well, Jack, I've never told you this before. Uh-huh. This just goes to me. I don't care about anybody else. To me, you're one of the world's greatest violinists.
You think so? Huh?
Oh, yes. You're just as good as what's his name?
Yasha Heifetz?
Yasha Heifetz.
No.
Well, Jack, you're just as good as
Isaac Stern?
Isaac Stern.
Oh, George.
I mean... and Jack, you're just as good as
Rubenstein?
Him, too.
He's a pianist.
What do I know about violinists? Jack, that was just a slip of the tongue. I really think you're the greatest.
Well, if you really feel that way, I just happen to have my violin here.
I don't... Oh, there it is. Yeah, well, I just happen to have my piano here.
Really?
There it comes.
George, you mean you're going to sing while I play?
Let me ask you a question. Mm-hmm. You're going to play while I sing? Anyway, I thought you'd rather see two gorgeous girls who are keeping time to some beautiful music together.
The world of beauty takes on new color with two new sun and fun shades of Lip Quick, world's first roll-on lip color. Pink Anise, a pulsating pink with all the intrigue of the East, all the brilliance of Oriental peonies. What a lift it gives every complexion, every costume. Peach Poodle, provocative peach with a cool French air. Whoever dreamed peach could give your beauty such a gay French accent? These two exciting colors come to your lips the only way a shade should today, with Lip Quick. Lip Quick, flowing lip color that rolls on automatically. See how easily Lip Quick outlines lips, how perfectly it shapes them. Just moisten lips, press together, and they're brilliantly beautiful. It's puppy love all over again with Pink Anise and Peach Poodle, two of 15 exciting young fashion shades found only in Lip Quick by Richard Hudnut.
There's a young boy, Bobby Darin. I've worked with him, and I've watched him become a tremendous success in the last year, and I've enjoyed every minute of it. In fact, I think he might turn out to be the second greatest singer in show business. Here he is, Bobby Darin.
look now, but there's somebody calling.
Who?
Why, your lady friend, that's who. And if I were you, well, if I were you, I'd get my little old self home. Won't you come home, Bill Bailey? Won't you come home? She cries the whole day long. I do the cooking, honey. I'll pay the rent. You know I done you wrong. Remember that rainy evening when I drove you out? Nothing but a fine-tooth comb home. Yes, I know I'm the plain honey. Ain't a shame. Bailey, won't you please come home? Oh, let's walk on home, Bill. Won't you come home, Bill Bailey? Won't you come home? She cries the whole day long. Yes, yes, yes. I do the cooking, honey. I pay the rent. You know, you know, you know I done you wrong. Remember that rainy evening I threw you out? Nothing but a fine-tooth comb and you was bald, honey. Ain't it a shame? No, I'm to blame, yes. Bailey, won't you please come? Bailey, won't you please come? Bailey, won't you please come? Oh, Bailey, won't you please come? Bailey, won't you please come? Keep on. Bailey, won't you please come? Go. Bailey, won't you please come? Let's walk. Bailey, won't you please come? 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 Go. Bailey, won't you please come? 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 One more time. Bailey, won't you please come? Oh!
Thank you. Thank you.
Bobby, you're a delight.
Thank you very much, Mr. Burns.
A lot has happened to you in the last year.
Yes, sir.
How does it feel to be 24 years old and to be one of the top recording stars? You know, the same thing could have happened to me, but when I was 24, Edison was 24, and he hadn't invented the phonograph yet.
Actually, I was really lucky, Mr. Burns. Sure was, because, after all, I owe most of my success to just one man.
Bobby, you don't have to say that.
Yes, I do, sir. Because, after all, where would I be without the guy that wrote Mac the Knife?
Yeah, well, that's who I was thinking of, too. Although, Bobby, I did have a little to do with your success. I didn't write Mac the Knife, but I wrote Elvis Presley's draft board and got Elvis in the army. That didn't hurt you either.
Oh, no, it sure didn't. Sure didn't hurt at all, no. Say, Mr. Burns.
Yeah?
Would you do me a favor, sir? Would you write another letter for Fabian?
Look, Bobby, how about singing a little song together?
Jeepers, Mr. Burns, I'd love to. I really would. But, you know, the last time we did the show, both of us sang a song together, and yeah, there might be a sameness, you know? It just might. Why don't, say, I have an idea. Why don't you sing a song with Betty Grable?
Betty Grable,
sure.
Huh?
Sure.
Yeah, yeah, that might be an idea. Mm-hmm.
Sure. I mean, after all, you've helped me enough. Why don't you do it to somebody else? I mean, why don't you do it for somebody else, is what I meant.
No. Betty Grable, yeah, she's a beautiful girl, and we could do a boy and girl number.
Certainly.
And I could give her every third line. I know that this is going to break your heart, but I've decided not to sing with you.
Well, I guess you just have to take the good with the bad.
Isn't he a wonderful boy? He took it so bravely. Singing with Betty Grable, yeah. Well, she's got a very exciting number. I'll let her do that first, and then I'll ask her. She's beautiful. She's charming. She's got a lot of talent. I might even give her every second line. Ladies and gentlemen, Betty Grable.
Thank you, thank you. I'm so delighted to see you all here this afternoon at this lovely press reception. And I do hope that you are going to like my book. My autobiography. The story of my life. Now, I'm not going to tell you all about it, but I would like to tease you with a few anecdotes and goodies from chapter 251. I haven't decided on a title yet, but I do have several to choose from. My Fickle, Fickle Ways. Or Inside of My Outside. Or Am I for real? And finally, I was too young to know. You know it. You're looking at a real sophisticate. The lust for life has been my goal. I've done a lot of things I shan't relate, but I refuse to rock and roll. I've been the inspiration for a song with spicy lyrics, my dear Cole. And I've been banned in Boston right along, but I refuse to rock and roll. It's not that it takes emotions that I lack. I've got what you might call respect for my sacroiliac. I dance with sailors in the USO, from which I won a Navy scroll. Doesn't show, but I refuse to rock and roll. And now it says here on page 5681, volume 3, that I've been to dinner with that ex-king man. He offered me a pink mink stole. The gifts he promised me would fill a van, but I refuse to. I suppose, but none a spinster would extol. The fact is, I am not the purest rose, but I refuse to rock and roll.
That number was thrilling. And that costume you're wearing is so exciting. Boy, I wish I had legs like yours. Even one.
Oh, George, I really enjoy working with you. You're a charming man. You've got a lot of personality and a lot of warmth.
Well, I'm glad you feel that way because we're going to sing together.
And a lot of nerve.
What?
I mean, I've got a lot of nerve to even want to sing with somebody like you.
Oh, well, that's all right, Betty. This is really going to be a great number for us. You see, it used to be a great hit for me. This is a great song. It's called I'm Tying the Leaves So They Won't Fall Down.
I'm Tying the Leaves
So They Won't Fall Down.
That was one of your big hits.
Betty, it might open a whole new career for you.
But that's what I'm afraid of. George. George, don't you think it would be better if you just sang all by yourself?
I'll be glad to. How does it go?
That's not the name of a song.
Look, Betty, this is my show, and I think we ought to do a number together.
But Mr. Burns...
Mr. Burns, two people who are going to sing together should call each other by their first names.
All right, Mr. Burns. What? And you can call me Mrs. James.
Look, Betty, this has gone far enough.
Betty, oh. Just a minute.
Yes, Jack.
Just a minute.
Yes, Jack.
You see, I heard you squabbling in here. And, Betty, I think you're wrong. I think you ought to do a song with George.
You do?
Yes.
Thanks, Jack.
What do you mean, thanks? I'm always on your side. And to make sure you come off, I'll be right here accompanying you on my violin.
You're gonna play while I sing?
Only when you sing.
What about her?
Who cares about her? You're...
The leaves by yourself.
Well, Betty, oh. I got you out of it, didn't I?
Oh, I can't tell you how much I appreciate it, Jack.
Now you can do your number without any interference. I'll just stand back here. You don't accompany you on the violin.
What'd you say, Mr. Benny?
Mr. Benny? I mean, what happened to Jack?
The same thing that happened to George.
Hold it. Wait a minute, Betty. All right, all right. I won't play for you. But you still owe me a favor, and I want you to do one thing for me.
All righty.
Now, I was just turned down by MGM for a part because there was a kissing bit in it, you see? And they felt that, I don't know, I wasn't romantic enough for it. Now, you're a beautiful girl. I mean, you've played those kind of scenes and parts. Do you mind if I kiss you? And then you can tell me how it was, huh?
Well, sure, sure. Ready?
Ready.
George! George!
What is it,
George?
Betty?
Hold this violin.
That Jack Benny, I've been holding his fiddle. January will be 31 years. You think I'm jealous? Just look at some home movies. I took it my pool last week.
This young lady is showing you a fabulous new hair coloring discovery. The first waterproof hair color rinse. New Color Glow. It's waterproof and it's wonderful. Color Glow doesn't wash out even underwater. Watch. The girl on the left has used another leading hair coloring rinse. The girl on the right used Color Glow. They both dry their hair with clean towels. And look, the other color lifts right off, while Color Glow stays on and will stay on for weeks. That's proof that Color Glow is waterproof. So if your hair is dull, faded, gray-streaked, give it new brilliance with waterproof Color Glow. Choose from a merry-go-round of gay shades. Blondest blondes to blackest blacks and everything in between. Use Color Glow. Then, rain or shine, you'll always have a dazzling glow of color in your hair. New waterproof Color Glow.
Polly. Polly, will you please listen to reason? We'll be a sensation together.
Jack, for the last time, no.
Please, Polly, look, I'll mute it.
No, Jack, this is my big number. I'd like to sing all alone.
I know that number. I'll play it with you.
Jack, the answer is still no, and will you please stop staring at me with those baby blue eyes?
Look, Polly, let me warn you about something. If you don't let me do this number with you, you know how you're going to wind up? You're going to wind up singing it with George Burns.
What a choice. That's like asking Bridget Bardot which one of the Three Stooges she'd like to do a love scene with.
Polly, can I talk to you?
Well, here comes Mo.
Polly, how...
Came here to pick some flowers. It's Mary's birthday.
Well, Jack, if it's Mary's birthday, I'll come over tonight and sing happy birthday to her.
It was yesterday.
Polly, how about all these flowers I got you?
Oh, I never received so many.
And this dressing room, I had it built especially for you.
George, I've never worked with anyone so thoughtful.
And how about that dress I got? For your opening
number.
Oh,
George, it's so beautiful, yes.
Isn't that pretty?
Yes.
Well, now that you feel good, Polly, I've got a favor to ask you.
George.
I've got a number.
George, before you do, I'd like to pay you a great compliment. You know, you and Jack Benny have been in show business for a lot of years.
About 1,000 years, yeah.
Yes. But there's a lot of difference between you.
Oh?
Do you know why Jack Benny was here?
No.
He was trying to get into my act. Now, can you imagine anybody trying to get into somebody else's act?
Polly, this number, I mean,
George, it's your show, and you wouldn't try to do a thing like that.
Flowers cost me $80.
I mean, the first principle of show business is is to give the other performer a chance. Jack should know that.
This dressing room cost $450.
And here you and Jack are friends. You'd think some of your showmanship would rub off on him.
That dress cost me $750.
How one performer can try to take advantage of another performer, I'll just never understand.
Polly, I was planning to let you keep the dress after the show.
You know, this is my big number, and I wouldn't share it with anyone. Not anyone. Now, George, what is it you want to ask me?
I came to get my flowers. And Polly, leave the dress after the show. It's Gracie's size.
You know, I hate to say this, but she was a big hit without me. Those kids, her and Bobby Darin and Betty Grable, they think they can put one over. Well, the three of them are supposed to do the next number, Buttons and Bows. The girls don't know this, but they're doing it with me. I tied Bobby Darin to a chair. Excuse me, I've got to make a change.
Now a western ranch is just a branch, nowhere junction to me.
Give me the city where living is pretty
and the gals wear finery. Take a look here.
East is east and west is west,
and the wrong one we had chose.
So let's go where they keep on wearing those frills and flowers and buttons and bows. Green things.
Standing out in buttons and bows.
All for standing out for self.
cursed that you homespun, but I love you longer, stronger, where you folks don't wear no gun. My bones denounced a buckboard bounce, and a cactus you hurts my toe.
Let's spare moose where gals keep using
those sticks and satins and linen that shows we're all yours in buttons and bows.
I love your headgear.
Now, even Eastern trimming where women are women.
And high silk toes and peekaboo clothes.
Right. French perfume that rocks the room.
We're all yours in buttons and bows.
Ready for buttons and bows.
George, they just did it.
What? Well, what do I do now?
Lead into the commercial.
Well, all right. I'd like to show you this newspaper with rave notices for a new home permanent hit. Gracie tried it and thinks it's just great. Now, girls, this has gone far enough. The party scene that's coming up, I'm using real champagne. It's costing me a fortune. The whole show is costing me a fortune. And you've got to make a decision. One of you girls have to sing with me. And it can't miss because at the finish of the number, I yodel. Now, which will it be?
I'd love to, George, but I've got laryngitis. She caught it from me.
I'm cooked. All right. Will you dance with me?
What did you say, George?
She caught it from you, yeah. Do you girls happen to have a relative in Gunsmoke named Chester? All right, no singing, no dancing. How about taking a little walk with me?
A walk?
A walk?
Sure.
Thank you.
party and have a lot of fun. I'll see you later, huh?
Gee, George really went all out for this party. Champagne, Nova Scotia salmon, imported caviar. I'm glad I brought my Bowser bag with me. It's Mary's birthday.
My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. Your looks are laughable, unphotographable, yet you're my is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? When you open it to speak, are you smart? If you really care for me, stay a little Valentine, stay each day, could be.
Music? Yes, Mr. Burns.
Well, there's over 500 songs here. They ought to love one of them.
They ought to.
I spared no expense. They can't turn me down.
Oh, Mr. Burns.
Charlie, did you bring my big song, I'll Be Waiting For You, Bill, when you come back from San Juan Hill? Well, go get it. That's my closing number. In the meantime, here's a great idea for you men. Get yourself some of those great Sportsman products. Tell them about it, Bob.
For Father's Day, Sportsman toiletries, because they're the finest men's toiletries you can buy. And how he'll love you for them. For example, Sportsman shaving lotion, that famous aftershave that gives a man that top of the morning feeling every day of the year. Then, Sportsman cologne for men. Ah, the fresh, clean scent that lends every dad a debonair air. It's the fragrance women love men to wear. And Sportsman gift sets. He'll really feel like a king with an airlight trio of Sportsman toiletries in this handsome travel kit. So go out tomorrow and buy him the sportsman toiletries he'd like best. Right, George?
Right, Bob. And to my son and daughter who are watching, Father's Day is June 19th. Now you know what I want. Don't forget, sportsman.
Sit down, Charlie. Sit down, everybody. Sit down. Down, everybody. Dad, how about the party? Nice party? Having fun? How about the food? Food good? Champagne was imported. Sit down, everybody. Down. Down. Down.
Now sit down, all of you. I think you kids ought to be ashamed of yourself. And you, Polly. And Betty. And Bobby here. And me. I'm the worst offender. Now, this is George's show. And George loves to sing.
It's true.
And we haven't given him a chance.
You.
George is my oldest friend. I've got hundreds of friends. But George is the oldest. I've heard George sing at parties, in the shower. I've heard George sing for 30 years.
32.
35 years. And it's time somebody else heard. Don't thank me. You don't have to thank me. You think George is a Johnny come lately. Do you know that this man made an album for the Edison Company more than 30 years ago with other great singers?
That's right.
But this man is permanent.
Thanks, Jerry.
You can go into any music shop. Their records are all gone. But George's is still there. Wait a minute, George. I'm not finished with that.
But you're
yet.
Finishing me.
George has had that voice down in him all these years.
A lot of years.
And it's improving with age. Right now, his voice is like a rare old wine. Like a fine old cheese. George Burns has got as much as any of the big singers of today. I don't care who you mention. Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Perry Como. Arthur Rubinstein.
He's a piano
player. What do I know about singer? George.
Jack, I know what you're trying to do, and believe me, you're doing it.
Please. I want you to remember that George has been a star in show business for 30 years.
32.
37 years.
37 years.
And you may ask me why. Ask me why. Ask me how. But that's show business.
I think you've taught us all a lesson, sir. And I know I, for one, would love to hear Mr. Burns sing a song.
Thank you.
Really would.
That goes for me, too.
Thanks.
And I feel the same right. way, George.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my opening number is a song
that's too late!
Too late! Look.
They've hurt you enough, George. And you're too hurt to give in.
I sing better when I'm hurt.
No, Lord, I'm not going to let you lower yourself.
I'll sing on my toes, Garchomp. What's
the matter with you? Don't you love George?
Then stop.
We're trying to teach these kids a lesson.
Look, Jack.
George, if I were you, I'd walk out on them.
Walk out on me? Look, they finally want to hear me sing. Why should I walk out
they
on them?
They don't deserve it. Now go, George, go.
Well,
take your music and go.
Jack.
You kids ought to be ashamed of yourself for what you've done to this man. Go, George, go.
Go.
And you traitor, you go.
Let's go into the property room. There's a piano there.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, my heart is breaking, but the show must go on. But first, I want you to hear a song without music. You've heard of a song without words. This is without music. And a one and a two.
Well, Charlie, there's the piano. Oh, hey, property man. Hey, Ross, stop painting. Did you want to sit right down, will you? Here, sit there. Here's a cigar. There you are. Now, let me light it for you. Put your feet right up here. Get yourself comfortable. I'm going to sing you a few songs. I love these songs. And I think you love them, too. And by the way, I want you to know that's a very good cigar. Okay, Grizzly Bear, Charlie. Out in San Francisco, where the weather's fair, they got a dance out there that's called the Grizzly Bear. All your other loving dances don't compare. Kind of spoony and a little less than croony. Talk about the bears that Teddy Roosevelt shot. They don't compare with what, well, San Francisco's got. Come on, honeydew, and I'll show to you the dance called the Grizzly. Hold it, hold it, hold it. That song is too great to finish. You know, when that song was popular, I was 18 years old. I did a ballroom dancing act, the Waltzing O'Connors. My name was O'Connor. And I used to change my name every week. I could never get a job with the same name twice. I loved show business. I used to walk around with makeup on my collar. I wanted the whole world to know I was an actor. One day things got so tough I had to wear a clean shirt. I couldn't afford makeup. Anyway, my name was O'Connor, and I was sitting in Farley Marcus's office. He was sort of a small-time booking agent trying to get a job. And a theater manager walked in. He said, where could I find Joe Healy? I says, I'm Joe Healy. I had so many names, I thought I was. And he gave me a contract to play the Myrtle Theater in Brooklyn for $15 for 3 days. On the contract that said monologist. I figured, how could I be bad for $15? So I went out and I stole Jim Thornton's act, who was a monologist. And a great one. But the trouble was, Jim Thornton was 65 years old and I was 18, so his material didn't exactly fit me. Well, I walked out on the stage at the Myrtle Theater. My opening line was, love is like the mumps. The only hour when you get it, the harder it goes with you. When you first fall in love, you're full of blunders like a cactus is full of prickles. And I looked off stage and the manager was doing this. Well, I figured I'm out here. I might as well do my act. I looked out at the audience and they were doing this. Well, there were more of them than there were of him, so I walked off stage. As I passed the manager, he wiped the makeup off my collar, stuck my pictures under my arm and set out. That's how they closed you in those days. They'd give you back your pictures. Until I met Gracie, I had my pictures stuck under my arm so often that for years I walked around like this. Anyway, I loved doing a single act. So I came back to that same theater 9 months later. My name was Willie Sachs. And I was rehearsing my opening song Monday morning. It was, if you'll notice on the program where he mentions all the acts, you take a look at number two, you see the name of Sachs. It doesn't say company or anything like that. It simply says assisted by his little baby head. Ooh, anyway, I sang about 30 or 40 choruses that I stole from Gallagher and Shin. And I was in the middle of my rehearsal when the manager walked down the stage and he says, hey, Sachs, aren't you the Joe Healy that was here 9 months ago who said love is like the mumps, the only hour when you get it, the harder it goes with you, first fall in love, you're full of blunders like cactus full of prickles. I said, yes, sir. Again, he wiped the makeup off my collar, stuck my pictures on my arm, and set out. I don't want to brag, but I'm the only actor in show business who was ever closed before he opened. Anyway, here's the chorus. Cuddle close to your baby. Snap your shoulders to the ceiling. Lordy, lordy, what a feeling. Hug up close to your lady. Close your eyes and do some napping. Something nice is going to happen. Hug up close to your baby. Swing her everywhere. Show you down the boat just how to go to Buffalo. Oh, doing the Grizzly Bear. Good song. I love these songs. I love verses. I'm a verse man. Sinatra needs choruses. Here's a cute verse. My kid brother, he's a lazy kid. One day's work is all the work he did. Wrote a song entirely wrong. Up in Yonkers, it's going strong. George M. Cohen and the other gang heard my brother when the song he sang. He said that it cannot miss. It's bound to be a hit. How could it miss? How could it miss? When the chorus goes like this. Oh, wait, 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 wait. When that was one of my hits. My name was Jimmy Glide. I did an act then called Goldie Fields and Glide. Goldie's right name was Jaime Goldberg. I found him in the laundry. He used to sing while he'd iron shirts. Sang a little bit like Anna Maria Albighetti. But the trouble was he couldn't sing without me.
So on the stage, when he'd sing, his motions would go something like this. From time to time in every climb, blessings come from above all. And then he turned the iron when he got to his sleeve. Well, we were not a very attractive trio. Goldie would sing like he was ironing, and I'd sing like I'm still holding the pictures under my arm. Anyway, we were booked for 3 days, you guessed it, the Myrtle Theater in Brooklyn. Monday morning, we were rehearsing our act. I was in the middle of, Heart of My Heart, I Love You, when the manager walked down the stage, and he said, "Hey, Glide, aren't you the Willie Sachs?" He said, "If you notice on the program that mentions all the acts, you take a look at number two, see the name of Sachs. He used to be Joe Healy, who said, love is like the mumps, the older you are, when you get it, the harder it goes, and your first floor love, you're full of lungs like cats full of pregnant." I never answered him. I just wiped the makeup off my collar, stuck my pictures under my arm, and left. Goldie went back to the laundry. Fields went into the insurance business, and I turned out to be Williams, a Brown and Williams singers, dancers, and roller skaters. Anyway, here's the chorus. Lily, lily of the valley. Lily, lily, let's be pally. You're the sweetest little flower of the lot. Oh, be my lily, and I'll be all forget me not. Here's a song. Here's a song I sang with the Pee Wee Quartet. Red Rose Rag. Down in the garden where the red roses grow, oh my, I want to go. Pluck me like a flower, cuddle me an hour, lovey, let me learn that red rose rag. Red leaves are falling in the rosy romance. Bees hum, come, now's your chance. Don't go hunting possums, mingle with the blossoms in their flowery bowery dance. Oh, honeymoon, shine on in June. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. Anyway, after 40 or 50 more names, 7 years later, I met Gracie. And we were a hit right away. And my ambition was to play the Myrtle Theater in Brooklyn and prove to that manager I could finish one performance without changing my name. And we booked it. We got there, and there it was up in lights. George Burns and Gracie Allen. The trouble was, it wasn't the Myrtle Theater anymore. The manager heard I was coming, and he changed it to the Jefferson. Well, here's the chorus. Pink, a pinky petal for your papa's pride. Beg your burning blush, hold it, baby Charlie. Bobby, what are you doing here?
Mr. Benny just started to play his violin.
Oh?
I'm only kidding. I want to say thank you very much for having me on the show again.
And don't forget, we're playing Vegas next month together. Watch your throat.
I shall.
Okay.
Good night.
Good night, Bobby. Pink, pinky petal for your papa's pride.
George.
Yes, Polly.
George, I just wanted to tell you how much fun the show was.
Thank you, Polly. And Gracie and I always watch you on To Tell the Truth, and you're the best.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night. Pink petal for your papa's pride. Thank you,
thank you, George, for a wonderful evening. I really enjoyed myself.
Thank you, Betty, and give my best to Harry.
My love to Gracie.
Thank you. Good night. Pinky petal for your papa's pride.
Thank
you,
Bert.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Pinky pet for your papa's pride. Thank you, Barney Blossom, for your blushing bride. Pull me with that wonderful wiggle wire. Charlie. He left. Come on, let's get our music.
Jack Taylor, Lady Killer. With the car, the clothes, but no beautiful girl. It seems she had suddenly acquired a very mysterious headache. Later that night, he remembered what he'd heard on the radio.
Don't try to brush bad breath away. Reach for Listerine.
Maybe that could be it. Maybe I could have bad breath.
And if you do remember, Listerine stops bad breath four times better than toothpaste. Germs in mouth and throat cause most bad breath. Toothpaste can't kill germs the way Listerine does, on contact by millions. Toothpaste covers only this small area, but you cover 2, 3, 4 times more mouth and throat surfaces the Listerine way, the recommended way of stopping bad breath. Every time you brush your teeth, reach for Listerine, your number one protection against bad breath. Listerine stops bad breath 4 times better than toothpaste. song I Refuse to Rock and Roll, courtesy of MGM, currently releasing The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn.
These slim, elegant, golden cases hold a great new, exciting beauty discovery. Lip Quick by Richard Hudnut. See how Lip Quick's creamy color flows on, outlines lips cleanly, shapes them perfectly, takes the place of lipstick, lip liner, and lip brush. Just moisten your lips, press together. Lips are beautiful with creamy, lasting color. Lipstick can break off, melt, lose its point. But Lip Quick's rounded tip applicator always shapes lips perfectly. Don't say lipstick, say Lip Quick by Richard Hudnut.
The George Burns Show has been brought to you by Richard Hudnut, America's first name in beauty, makers of Lip Quick, the world's first roll-on lip color, Color Glow, the first waterproof hair color rinse, Fashion Quick, the first no-odor home permanent, and Fabulous Light and Bright Hair Lightener. Now, from Richard Hudnut, good night.